In today's video, we're going to be dividing three-digit numbers by two-digit numbers. We'll start by taking the dividend and placing that underneath our little bus stop, we can call it. And the divisor, we're going to put on the outside. Now that we know how to lay out our sum, let's talk about the process that we're going to be going through. These four steps will always be the same. So you're always going to cycle through them in the same order. Let's just focus on the multiplication and division part just for a second, because this is the part that I feel causes the most amount of time wastage and where the problems usually creep in. So let's start off by looking at a method that we can help fix these two steps. What I'm talking about here is taking the 12, the divisor, and writing it out in terms of its times table, just like this. Now we can start with the first step, which is division. So we're going to say, can 4 be divided by 12? No, it can't. So we expand it and we say, okay, can 40 be divided by 12? And from my times tables, we can see that yes, it can. And the answer is 3. Now we can move on to multiplication, where we're going to say, okay, well, 3 times 12 is what? And thankfully, because of our times tables, we don't even need to calculate this because the answer is right there. So we can just simply write it in. Now we can move straight into subtraction, where we're going to take 40 and take away 36. Now we have 4, and we once again ask ourselves, well, can 12 go into 4? No, it can't. And that's where the bring down step comes into play. So we bring down the 8 and then start our process all over again. And we say, okay, well, now can 12 go into 48? Once again, using our multiplication table, we can see that yes, it can. And it can go in 4 times. Next up is multiplication, where we say, okay, well, 4 times 12 is what? And once again, it's done for you. So here you just need to look at your times tables and the answer is 48. So we write that in and we move on to the next step, which is subtraction. So we take 48 minus 48 and the answer there is 0. And because there are no more digits to bring down, we can stop there and we don't need to go any further. Let's try a slightly trickier one. As before, you're going to set up your sum ready for long division. Next, you're going to write out the 23 times table, ready to help and support you. And then we can start with step 1, where we say, okay, well, can 9 be divided by 23? No, it can't, but 97 can be. And we can see that it goes in 4 times. And 4 times 23 is 92, which we'll take away from 97, resulting in 5. Now, once again, 23 can't go into 5, so we'll bring down reinforcements. And after bringing that down, we're going to start our process all over again and start back at division. Here we'll see that 23 can go into 59 twice, and 2 times 23 is 46. After that, we'll do our taking away, resulting in 13. And because there are no more digits, we can leave it there and just have a remainder of 13. And here's 4 for you to try. The answers will be coming up next, so pause if you don't want to see. I hope that helped. If it did, give us a like and subscribe, and we'll see you for more videos soon.